गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. लास्ट टाइम वी हैड स्टार्टेड विद लेसन 13 फ्रेजेज एंड क्लॉजेज एंड वी हैड फिनिश्ड अप टू एडजेक्टिव क्लॉजेज, राइट. नाउ लेट अस स्टडी फर्दर व्हाट आर एडवर्ब क्लॉजेज. वी हैड स्टडीड नाउन क्लॉजेज एज वेल एज एडजेक्टिव क्लॉजेज. नाउ वी शैल मूव ऑन टू एडवर्ब क्लॉजेज. एडवर्ब क्लॉजेज सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज दैट परफॉर्म्स द फंक्शन ऑफ एन एडवर्ब इन अ सेंटेंस इज कॉल्ड एन एडवर्ब क्लॉज. Now, what is adverb? Adverb is the word which adds to the meaning of a verb. Verb is the action word in the sentence, right? Adverb also adds to the meaning of an adjective. It also adds to the meaning of an adverb again, right? So, that you have to remember. The definition of adverb you should first know. Then only you'll be able to trace out the adverb clause. Look at the following examples. Manan kept walking until he reached the main crossing. He kept walking. Walking is the action going on. Until what? Kab tak wo chalta raha? Until he reached the main crossing, right? So this is an adverb clause. It is explaining the word walking. It is useless to argue since the decision has already been taken. Argue karna useless kyun hai? Useless is the actual verb, right? Why it is useless? Since the decision has been already taken. He looked for a good hotel so that he could spend the night comfortably. Good hotel. Why he looked for a good hotel? So that he can spend the night comfortably. The clauses printed in the bold are all adverbs. Adverb clauses are introduced by when, while, before, after, since, as soon as, right? All these are used to introduce adverb clauses. These are kind of prepositions to show time, where, wherever, to show place, because, as, since, to show reason, so that, to show effect, result, consequence, so that, to show purpose, right? What is the purpose of the action being done? Then, if, unless, provided, that, to show condition, although, even if, even though, to show contrast, as if, to show manner, then as so, so as to show comparison. Now exercise 2, let us move on. Say whether the underlying clauses in the following passage are noun, adjective or adverb, right? Now I'll read the entire passage and tell you as and when the clauses come. A little girl said that she did not like roses. What did the little girl say? That she did not like roses. Yahan pe break hai. This is a separate set of clause again, right? So this is, what did she say? That she did not like roses. So that is a noun clause. Then further, because a rose has thorns. Kyun usko roses pasand nahi tha? Because a rose has thorns. Now this is a reason, not liking, right? She is saying, not liking the roses, what is the reason behind it? It is this. So it is more expressing the reason. So it is an adverb clause, right? Reason is reason about not liking. Then whenever she plucked a rose, its thorns scratched her. Whenever she plucked the rose, right? Its thorns scratched her. Whenever, it is starting with when, right? It is telling you the time when the action is being done. So it is an adverb clause. Then sometimes her dress also got torn. She wondered why the flower god had given a rose those awful thorns. What did she wonder? Why the flower god had given a rose those awful thorns. She was wondering. What she was wondering? This. So it is a noun clause. What ka answer mil raha hai? To wo noun clause hai. Her mother said, my dear, if there were no thorns, the cows and goats would eat the flowers up. Right? My dear, the cows and goats would eat the flowers up. Right? Kab eat karenge flowers ko? If there were no horns, right? Now, if is showing you a condition, to show a condition here, right? So, if is an adverb clause. Then further, the thorns which you do not like protect the flowers from the animals, right? The thorns protect the flowers from animals. Ye principal clause hua, and rest is सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज, तो ये विच डू यू डू नॉट लाइक, क्या तुमको अच्छा नहीं लगता, थॉर्न्स, जो तुम्हें पसंद नहीं है, राइट? सो दैट इज़ एन एडजेक्टिव क्लॉज, बिकॉज दिस ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स इज टेलिंग यू मोर अबाउट द थॉर्न्स, सो इट इज़ एडजेक्टिव क्लॉज. देन फर्दर, वेन द फ्लावर गॉड मेड द रोज, इट वॉज सो ब्यूटिफुल दैट ही हैड टू गिव इट थॉर्न्स टू सेव इट, राइट? वेन द फ्लावर गॉड मेड द रोज, वेन, अगेन इट इज़ टेलिंग यू द टाइम, राइट? द टाइम स्लॉट इज बींग डिस्कस, सो इट इज़ एन एडवर्ब क्लॉज. देन फर्दर, द रोज हैज़, सॉरी, द सेकेंड क्लॉज इज ही हैड टू गिव इट थॉर्न्स टू सेव इट, राइट? सो ब्यूटिफुल दैट, अगेन इट इज स्टार्टिंग विद दैट, दैट इज टेलिंग यू, सो दैट इज शोइंग यू अ पर्पज, वॉट वॉज द रीजन टू गिव इट थॉर्न्स, बिकॉज इट शुड बी प्रोटेक्टेड, राइट? सो इट इज ऑल्सो एन एडवर्ब क्लॉज, द रोज टू सेव इट, द रोज has thorns because it is so beautiful and precious, right? Why it has thorns? Because it is so beautiful and precious. Now, because is telling you the reason. Again, it is an adverb clause. All those things that you consider to be beautiful have to be treated in a special way. What type of things that you consider beautiful? So, this is an adjective clause. It is telling you more about those things. Now in exercise 3, complete these sentences by adding clauses according to the instructions for oral practice. So we are crossing this out because it's difficult to add up, keeping in mind the clauses, right? So now let us move on to lesson 14, that is relative clauses. What are relative clauses that we shall study? Defining a relative clause. You have already read about adjective clauses, and adjective clause is also a relative clause. A relative clause tells us which person or thing or what kind of person or thing the speaker means, right? What type of person the speaker means, that is, it is giving you, it is playing the function of an adjective in the sentence. It is telling you more about the noun in the sentence, right? It is normally introduced by relative pronouns like who, which, that, whose, whom, and relative adverbs like when and where. Look at these sentences. A lady who lived in our neighborhood came to our help. Kaun si lady? Right? A lady came to our help is the principal clause. Lady kaun si hai? Who lived in our neighborhood? So, who lived in our neighborhood is the relative clause. And who is the relative pronoun which is defining the word lady. Who lived in our neighborhood tells us which lady. Then God helps those who help themselves. Kisko help karta hai God? Those who help themselves. Now who help themselves is the relative clause. And who is the relative pronoun. Who help themselves tells us what kind of people. Clauses printed in bold letters are relative clauses. A relative clause is a type of subordinate clause modifying a noun or a pronoun and giving detailed information about the person or thing the noun or pronoun refers to, right? It is telling you a detailed information about the noun or pronoun that person is referred to. किसी भी नाउन या प्रोनाउन के बारे में आपको एडिशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन वो देता है, दैट इज़ व्हाई इट इज़ कॉल्ड अ रिलेटिव क्लॉज एंड इट इज़ अ काइंड ऑफ एडजेक्टिव क्लॉज. रिमेंबर दैट रिलेटिव क्लॉजेज आर ऑलवेज अ काइंड ऑफ एडजेक्टिव क्लॉजेज. यू हैव ऑलरेडी रेड अबाउट एडजेक्टिव क्लॉजेज एंड एडजेक्टिव क्लॉज इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ रिलेटिव क्लॉज. एंड विच एवर इज द फर्स्ट वर्ड लाइक हु, दैट, विच, दे आर कॉल्ड रिलेटिव प्रोनाउन्स. रिलेटिव क्लॉजेज यूजअली फॉलो द नाउन्स और प्रोनाउन्स दे मॉडिफाई and are usually introduced by a relative pronoun such as who, whose, whom, which or that, or a relative adverb like when and where. Write this also, it's important. Then who, how we use who and where we use who, that we will see now, the use of who. We use who in relative clause when we are talking about people, not things, right? Generally things के लिए हम लोग which use करते हैं. ये normal unit relative pronouns जब हम लोग बिना clauses के करते हैं तो भी same apply होते हैं, right? Same way it is in clauses also. We use it in place of he, she, they. Further, the boy, he stood first in the class, is my cousin. So how you will write the sentence? The boy who stood first in the class is my cousin. कौन सा boy who stood first in the class? Now this is the relative clause. And who is the relative pronoun? It is telling you something about the boy. The people, they live in big cities, usually have an unhealthy lifestyle. The people who live in big cities usually have an unhealthy lifestyle. So who live in big cities? कौन किसके बारे में बता रहा है? People. Who is what? A relative pronoun. An atheist is a person who does not believe in God. What is the name of the man who took you to the hospital? Anyone who is interested in taking part in this play should contact Mr. Sanjay Kumar. Now, anyone who is interested, who? किसके बारे में? Anyone. जो जिसको who is interested to take part in this play, right? So who is the relative pronoun? In most cases we use that in place of who. The boy that stood first in the class is my cousin. The people that live in big cities usually have an unhealthy lifestyle. Which, that. We use which or that in a relative clause when we are talking about things, not people. As I said earlier, we use which or that for things, not for people. For people, generally, we use who. Where are the books? They are lying on the table. Where are the books? Which, that. Which are lying on the table or that are lying on the table. The syringe which or that has been used once should be immediately disposed of. I work for a company which or that produces gas stoves. I don't like movies which or that show excessive violence. That can normally be used in place of both who and which. But there are certain cases where we have to use that. We use that after adjectives in superlative degree. Dr. Mehta was one of the best speakers that spoke on naturopathy. This is the most ridiculous movie that has ever hit the screen. We use that after the words all, any, anything, none, nothing, etc. This is all that I possess. She approved of nothing that I did. Then next one, if we needed a word to refer to both a person and a thing, we would naturally use that, right? Dono cheez ko agar address karne ke liye hame ek word chahiye, then we use that. Both the bird and the nest that were shown in the picture appear to be strange, right? So bird is a living thing, nest is a non-living thing. For both we have used that as a relative pronoun. Both the bird and the nest that were shown in the figure, right, in the picture. Now that and what,